Hello, I'm Andi, and I'm going to use, this is a program for Tarot Monthly Horoscope for Zodiac Signs for the month of May 2017, and this is for you coming from Gemini. All right, I'm going to shuffle my cards quickly, and the first card that I pull is going to be for the first 15 days of May. So let me pull this card, and I have to turn it around, which means that it was not presented itself well, and therefore you don't have much control over the first 15 days for you coming from Gemini. Alright, now, in spite of that, this is not really a very bad card for you. So let me start for the first 15 days talking to you about romance. The danger here is that you can be misled. You will find a romance in the first 15 days. You will be able to convince the romance to your favor, but you are not really getting the full picture. You are a person who is dreaming about the good things. This is the card for some of you who want to look at it. And this shows that the reflection of the situation in romance is not very steady, not very honest, and you have to be a little careful for you coming from Gemini for the first 15 days of May. And so, what is the worry? The worry is that you may find that you are with a partner who is very aggressive in his or her approach, and also that a person who may change, that person may change his or her mind very often. So, do accept the romance is not totally against you, but have a wait and see and learn the character of that person. Okay? Regarding your marriage, the card shows that you are not being honest with yourself about the situation of your marriage. And basically, for the first 15 days of May, this card says that while the situation is to your favor and you are in control of your marriage for the first 15 days, yet there beneath the surface is brewing some problems, and you have to identify these problems. One of the problems is that either you or your partner may be guilty of straying. If it is you, stop it. And if it is your partner, find out the cause for that. Don't quickly go to accuse your partner. Find out the cause for that, and then try to look at the situation. So the card basically tells you, in regarding your marriage, to look at yourself first, because you may be contributing problems to your marriage. But the good news is that the first 15 days, there are signals on this card that show that you can find the easy way out of trouble from your marriage. So it's very repairable. Overall, the general family situation is a little bit of turmoil, a little bit of uncertainty, a little bit of not really knowing which direction to take. So you may have a lot of pressure from children, from siblings, from parents, and from your marriage partner as well. So try to remain calm. Try to remain calm and focus on what's important. Okay? Now, I want to talk to you about career for your first 15 days. Now, this is a good card for a job. If you are having a job, that means if you have a career, you are going to get very good news. And the good news says that it's got to do with money, it's got to do with position. And so, you are now being rewarded in the first 15 days where your job is concerned. Regarding your business, for you coming from Gemini, first 15 days of May, the news is very good, and it produces more money, more position, more support. So, in the area of career, in the area of business, you are doing very well in the first 15 days of May with plenty of support. It shows that what you are trying to do, you can beat the competition if you are in business. Okay, now let me pull another card, which will have to do with the last 15 days. Don't go away, because I'm going to give you your good dates, your bad dates. I'm going to also give you, it's getting sticky here. I'm also going to give you your good cycles regarding good colors and what directions to give, and also of what ages some of you are going to benefit a lot. Okay, let me shuffle these cards quickly. All right, and let me put this down and produce one card. Now, this card has got to do with the last 15 days of May for you coming from Gemini. I have to turn it around, and that shows that basically you don't have much control. You don't have much control. And so, why? Let's start with your romance area. It says that you will tend to be a person who will be very aggressive in your approach, very argumentative in romance, and very provocative, and you produce conflict very easily through your words. So use soft words, don't use be sarcastic, and try to use words which are encouraging your partner in romance rather than getting that partner down. That way your last 15 days can be improved. You have to, because the signal here is that is your lack of self-confidence that's actually making the situation very touchy. Some inferiority complexes you may have, and these are contributing to create conflict with your romance partner in the last 15 days of May. Regarding your marriage, the news is about the same. Conflict comes very easily. Lightning strikes very fast, which means your words could be coming out very fast out of your mouth like lightning. And before you know what you said, you already said it, and it creates conflict. So be careful that the last 15 days, plenty of arguments can also come about. And well, that's about for your romance area. Regarding your marriage, you have to be cautious. As I said, don't allow conflict to take over, and don't allow yourself to be too argumentative as well. Now, there is a planet of this. The planet is called Neptune. It's on this card, and it shows that there are undercurrents in your marriage area in the last 15 days. So in the last 15 days, some issues about personal affairs of the past can also come up. Okay. Overall, this card doesn't show breakdown in romance or breakdown in marriage or breakdown in family areas. It just brings provocation. So remove the provocation from your side and you will do much, much better. Now, regarding your career, your job, the last 15 days are very good. They produce plenty of opportunities. If you want to change a job, the last 15 days of May are the best time to go about looking and applying for a new job. But you're going to even get good news where you are. More money, a better position. You are climbing. You are climbing with this card. You are climbing. And so promotions are also seen for you. You have the ability of catching your boss's eye. I can see from here. So there's some very good news coming for you for the last 15 days of May for you coming from Gemini. Regarding business, you are going to attract plenty of business possibilities in the last 15 days. The information you have, the way you calculate things, the way you communicate, it shows that you are moving upscale and you are able to attract business, make good business contacts. You are climbing the ladder of success as well. You have the determination level as well. So you are going to do very well in the area of business in the last 15 days. From what I can see from these cards, okay? Now, I'm going to hold up both these cards, the first 15 days and the last 15 days, and I'm going to now talk to you about your good ages in the month of May, to look forward to these special ages. If you happen to be the ages of 17 or 26 or 35 or 44 or 53 or 62 or 71 or even 80, then you are going to be pretty lucky in the month of May, you coming from Gemini, in all areas of your life. If you are not of these ages that I mentioned, never mind. You just follow what I said, that way the advice I give you. Now I'm going to talk to you about your good dates for you coming from Gemini for the month of May. And the good dates I've chosen are the 4th, the 13th, the 22nd and the 31st. These cards show that on these 4 days and nights of the month, you are going to be very, very lucky. So be active, socialize, talk to your bosses, talk to your colleagues, go and see your business people. Go all out for these 4 days and nights, and you are going to connect very nicely. I'm now going to give you the colors which I prefer you to wear for the month of May, you coming from Gemini. And the colors I've chosen are the color white, is the color white. Try to contact white, undergarments, top garments, pillowcase, bed sheets, towels. Get a piece of white cloth and just hold it, and the energy will charge into you. And this is a very powerful color to have for you coming from Gemini for the month of May. And then I'm going to talk to you about your best directions. The best direction I've chosen from these cards is northeast. So if you face northeast and to meditate, to make your wishes, to just focus on what you want, to allow good energy to come to you, you are going to find a lot of that goodness coming for you. So try to face the directions from this card, which are northeast. Okay. Now regarding your health. Regarding your health, my main worry from looking from this card is your breathing areas. So your breathing areas may produce problems for you. And your breathing areas can include asthma or colds or coughing and things like that. My other worry for you coming from Gemini looking at these cards are something quite serious to do with your heart. So if you have palpitations, if you perspire, what we call cold sweat, which means you are not in the hot sun, you may be in an air-conditioned room in a cool country, but you still perspire, that is also a signal. So if you have pain where your heart is, right here, well, go and see a cardiologist if I were you. These are the two signals. They show there could be stress upon you that will be stress to your heart. Okay? Well, that's my advice for you for the month of May, for you coming from Gemini. And I'm already Skyping. My Skype of 90 minutes with you will be based on your full date of birth, your time of birth, looking at your palms. And if you prefer, also for me using your tarot, the tarot, Kabbalistic tarot cards, I will do that as well. So do go to Facebook, follow me, communicate, make a date to Skype, and or just go to Skype itself and leave me a message. And for your next 5, 6, or 7 years, I will detail, I will advise you in all areas of your life. Until then, thank you and goodbye.